Welcome back. It's Faith Friday here at ABC, and we are so excited about our next guest. They are breaking barriers as the first openly transgender person to be elected as Bishop of the Sierra Pacific Synod of the Evangelical Lutheran Church. Easy for me to say. It's one of the largest Christian denominations in the country with over 3.3 million members. And in this new role as bishop, they will oversee about 200 congregations in both California and Nevada.
So let's bring in now Reverend Dr. Megan Rohr of San Francisco's Grace Evangelical Lutheran Church. And look at that smile. It is so good to have you here. You officially take the new position in September. So you got a little time now, but still, how did you get the news? It's a big deal no matter what. But for you, how did you take that news when you first heard you'd be taking over this role?
I think at first I was shocked and surprised. Anytime you do something that's brand new, it's always surprising to know that I'll step into that role. But the good news is that I might be the person stepping into something historic, but it really was the folk of the Sierra Pacific Synod who had faith in me. They did the historic thing. They voted, and I'm just so grateful they had faith in God and faith in what we're up to and faith in me to be their leader.
And Reverend, your journey to become bishop has not been an easy one. You grew up in South Dakota. You talk about how you experienced religious abuse firsthand, and yet you say it was that experience that actually brought you closer to God.
Absolutely. Being able to rise through the depths of maybe what other people think about you or what I think about myself, it reminds me of that one of my favorite hymns, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. And sometimes, you know, it takes folk wondering if God truly loves you to be able to articulate why God certainly is next to my side and next to the side of everyone out there who's yearning and hoping that God can be with them and is inspired by Jesus's message.
Now, we always, I was just about to say, this is the part where we were supposed to hand it over to you to give us some words of faith and inclusion and hope going into the weekend. You've already given us so many. So we're going to ask you to continue what you have been doing and give folks, I guess, just some words of love and inclusion, kind of your message they can take with them going into the weekend.
I've been reading Ephesians 3, where it talks about how Jesus expands our understanding of God, showing us the breadth and the depth and the height of what is to come. And so I just want to encourage anyone who has felt like their faith is being stretched to remember that God is with you and for you. And if your neighbor is stretching you to love bigger, love bigger. If your neighbor is stretching you to be more patient, do the best you can. Or maybe your kids are stretching you in all the directions they're stretching you. But know that God adores you, that I adore you. And if you got a little extra time this weekend, tell people you are grateful for them and that you love them too. And if you haven't heard it from your own faith community, come join us in the Lutheran Church. We'd love to have you in the pews to pray with us.
I love it there at the end. Reverend Dr. Megan Rohr, it is so good to have you. Congratulations. You're starting the post in September officially. We hope to check in with you again down the road, all right?
Thank you very much.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.